Hello, Deep Staters. In a recent column by Pat Buchanan, the political commentator, he wrote this, quote, "It may one day be said that the coronavirus delivered the death blow to the New World Order, to a half century of globalization, and to the era of interdependence of the world's great nations," end quote. Pat sounds gleeful in his assertion, but I'm here to put a damper on his enthusiasm and inform him that he's 100% wrong. The New World Order, or NWO, is allegedly a clandestine, totalitarian world government with a globalist agenda to erase the borders of all countries and states, ruling over all people. This government will control the flow of events from behind the scenes, nudging people's behavior constantly and covertly to fulfill their agenda. It's mentioned in the Bible, on the back of the US dollar bill, and featured in our web series, The Deep State. The globalist agenda is about power and control. And fear is always the best way to achieve that. COVID-19 gave the globalists a peek into the impact a single event can have on controlling our behavior and allowing us to sacrifice some of our civil liberties, just as 9/11 did. Look at what this invisible monster did in just a matter of weeks. The Times of Israel reported that Iran deployed its security forces to clear the streets nationwide so that all of its citizens can be checked for the virus. This was done in 24 hours, for 80 million people. In the United States, Fox News reported that the National Guard was deployed in at least 6 states as part of the response to the virus. What a great way to implement martial law whenever the globalists want it. The Israel publication Haaretz reported that the Israeli government approved a proposal to allow its security services to perform mass surveillance on Israelis' phones without requiring a court order. And they passed this law late at night when most people were sleeping. The World Health Organization recommended avoiding cash because it carries germs and spreads infections. This brings us closer to the cashless society, as countries such as Sweden have successfully done, and the rise of central bank digital currencies. Once cash is gone, then all of your transactions are captured in digital form. And with one click, access to your money for necessities like feeding your family can be shut off, and acquiring more money is shut down because it restricts your employer from adding your pay to that account. This is all reflected in the book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 17. And the second beast required all people, small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hand or on their forehead, so that no one could buy or sell unless he had the mark. And boy, talk about power. The mayor of Champaign, Illinois, signed an executive order giving herself the power to order the seizure of firearms, ammunition, alcohol, and gasoline during the pandemic. The order also enables the local government to take possession of private property and cut off an individual's access to gas, water, or electricity. Denmark's parliament unanimously passed an emergency coronavirus law, which gives health authorities powers to force testing, treatment, and quarantine with the backing of the police. A law professor at Copenhagen University said the measures were unlike anything passed in the last 75 years, and certainly the most extreme since the Second World War. Google-owned YouTube released this announcement, saying that it will censor more videos during the pandemic using technology instead of its employees to keep them safe at home. YouTube's process had always used both technology and real people to censor videos. But COVID-19 is the reason why only technology is being used. Why can't those YouTube employees review videos from the safety of their homes? Lots of people are working from home during the pandemic. It's just another step towards censorship. Like I said earlier, the answer is control. It's the ability for the NWO to centralize power and control and reduce the population. I mean, look at the degree of control. The COVID-19 virus stopped people worldwide from assembling peacefully, which here in the United States is a right under the First Amendment. So if you had a protest plan, it's not going to happen. And how about these other events that were stopped? The Grand Mosque in Mecca stopped Muslims from worshiping at the holy site for the first time in its history. Catholic churches suspended its services until further notice. Free public libraries are also closed until further notice. We can't shake hands or hug anymore, alienating us from each other. Social distancing is the clinical term for it. We're locked in our homes like caged animals in a zoo. And yes, Pat Buchanan, the New World Order is the zookeeper. And there's no escape. So, Pat and any others out there who believe COVID-19 has crushed the NWO should consider these points I made today, read the Bible, or watch our web series. As Alex Turner says in episode 1,
they're fulfilling the prophecy, Gerald. Think about it this way. If it doesn't come true, if it isn't fulfilled, if just one prophecy doesn't come to pass, then God's word is a lie.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this vlog, please hit the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel, The Deep State Web Series, to watch our first 4 episodes and more insightful vlogs.
They call us the Deep State, but we're the good guys.